In case you are familiar with Q for Python, the project, you might have heard the word Shiboken. So this is a brief introduction for the Shiboken, which is a Python binding generator tool. Just for context, when we are talking about Q for Python, we involve PiSet, which is the binding generations for the whole Qt API, and Shiboken generator and module. The generator, it's a tool that generates the binding itself. So on the other hand, we have the module, which is nothing else like a helper module. It contains a couple of functions that will help your interaction with C++ within Python. There are many other solutions of these projects, but overall, these are all the topics that the Qt for Python project involves. A brief history is that the project started around 2008, when the developers started to develop PiSet, and they saw that Shiboken was a really good idea to generate the binding from it. Then later on, in 2016, it was accepted as an official Qt for project member, and the initial release was in 2018 for Qt 5.12. To install PiSet, you can run the following command, pip install PiSet 6 for the latest. This will automatically install the dependency of the Shiboken module, as you can see there on the diagram, but not about the generator. If you are really interested into installing the Shiboken generator, you can either build it from source or get some Python package snapshots from our CI that you can easily configure and start using. The main reason of not having this publicly published is because there is a hard dependency of libclang. So let's talk about binding generation. For Shiboken, you can find all the documentation in this URL. In a nutshell, the whole process to generate the PiSet bindings goes as follows. Shibokens go into the Qt headers and get all the information of all the Qt modules and classes. We complement that information with a type system, which is nothing else like a group of XML files where you can describe many changes to the Qt API and mostly adaptations from C++ to Python land. After that, Shiboken processes information and generates some C++ files that uses the standard Python implementation, which is CPython code using that CPython API, that later on we can compile and create the PiSet module. Since we briefly talked before about the double functionality of Shiboken, you can have here the module on one side with functions that maybe will access the C++ pointer for the underlying objects, maybe you can check the ownership, or even abstraction classes like the void pointer. On the other hand, the generator, it's mainly defined to generate bindings for C++ projects. What are the common use cases of Shiboken? The first one, and the most simple one, is that let's imagine that you have a test application. This is only a simple C++ application that has one function called hello that will print a message. Besides your library, you will require a main header file that includes all the headers of your projects, in this case only one, and also a type system, where you can specify the package name and the signature of the functions that you would like to include. If you look at this example, we can see that the implementation of the C++ file is quite simple, only a function called hello, and this is the Python file they would like to execute. After configuring CMake and building the whole project, we will be able to copy around this shared library file, in this case called simple.so for Linux, that later on we can import from Python. So here you can see that it works from Python. Another really important use case is the exposure of custom widgets. So let's say you have a C++ custom widget written in Qt, then you can expose it easily to Python. Here we can see in this small animation, on the top, there is the typical wiggly widget example from Qt, where the code has been fully translated from C++ to Python on the top, And on the bottom, you can see the C++ code, but exposed to Python through Shiboken. As you can see, there is no difference in the behavior there. The most popular application of Shiboken is to combine and do hybrid applications between Python and C++. We can see here a cute C++ application where we are writing Python code inside. As you can see there, we are trying to get in reference to the main windows, and we are altering the font size of application. In this case, what is being done here is that the Qt C++ application includes a Python interpreter with PiSet, exposing the main window object of this Qt C++ application. So in this case, we can try to write plugins to alter the Qt C++ application. Here you can see that we are finding the Qt action that includes the word run, which is this one, and we will change the text to run with many U's. Once we execute this, you can see the change in the whole application. Sometimes writing the type system is a little bit complicated. For that, we developed this commercial tool called Shiboken Wizard, where you can specify the options of your C++ application. It doesn't matter, maybe Qt, only C++. And then you can generate the CMake file and also the type system for your project. If you want more information, here you have the main product landing page of the Qt for Python project, the wiki page, which has public contributions, and the official documentation, where you can find all the examples, videos, and tutorials about the project.